Hockey is back is an untrue statement, so stop saying it, but today was a very fun day. Today on Tim and Sid, Gary Bettman announced the plan, or most of it anyway, for how hockey is going to return. How hockey is going to return being the key there. We only got an answer to a few of the questions. What? Hockey. Simple enough. Why? Because the overwhelming majority of fans want it back. Money. It's money, but it doesn't sound as nice. But I mean, most of us do want it back. I want it back, just under the right circumstances. Where? Well, we don't really have a where, but we have some potential wheres. The hub cities still under consideration are Chicago, Columbus, Dallas, Edmonton, Los Angeles, Minnesota, Pittsburgh, Toronto, Vancouver, and Vegas. We did appear to get an answer to how many wheres, which is two. So two of those eight cities will be hub cities. Most people I talk to seem to think Vegas is a lock and it makes sense. Their hotel situation is far greater than most places. Toronto, Edmonton, and Vancouver involve crossing a border, so have fun with that. And Bettman did mention wanting to avoid places that had too many cases of COVID-19, which is obviously an ever-changing constantly changing situation. When? We got a partial answer for that. From reporter Chris Johnston, Gary Bettman says NHL training camps won't open before July 1st. So training camps won't even open until at least July 1st. That's July 1st at the earliest. And then who knows how long training camp's gonna be. 2 weeks minimum, I would think. I should probably mention that I pulled that out of thin air. Who? That got a lot of people talking. They confirmed the long-standing rumor that it is going to be a 24-team playoff, or sort of playoff. They confirmed that the top four teams in both the Western and Eastern Conference at the time of the stoppage of the season will have a sort of mini tournament against each other to establish who the seeds 1 through 4 are. Notably, the Boston Bruins are getting completely screwed by this. From NHL Public Relations on the Eastern Conference, the top four seeds who will play in a round robin for seeding are Boston, Tampa, Washington, and Philadelphia. And then who is kind of blending into how? In the best of five qualifying rounds, so all these series will be best of five, the Pittsburgh Penguins, who were fifth, will take on the Montreal Canadiens, who were 12th, the Hurricanes, who were sixth, will take on the Rangers, who were 11th, the Islanders, who were seventh, will take on the Panthers, who were 10th, and the Leafs, who were eighth, will take on the Blue Jackets, who are ninth. In the West, your top four seeds who are playing in a round robin against each other, the reigning Stanley Cup champion St. Louis Blues, the Colorado Avalanche, Vegas Golden Knights, and Dallas Stars. In the best of five qualifying round, the Oilers, number 5, will be taking on the Blackhawks, number 12. Sure don't feel like a number 12. The Predators, who were 6th, will be taking on the Coyotes, who are 11th. The Canucks, who were 7th, will be taking on the Wild, who are 10th. And the Flames, in an all-Canadian matchup, who are 8th, will be taking on the Jets, who are 9th. So, the top four teams will be playing in a round robin, meaning they'll be playing 3 games each, I believe. The other teams will be playing in best of fives. But the Stanley Cup Final will be a best of 7 series. The Eastern and Western Conference Final will both be best of 7 series. The semifinal and the quarterfinal, they don't know yet. It'll either be best of 7 or best of 5. I guess it sort of depends on when the season or playoff resumes. Speaking of which, the regular season, done. Officially done. Which sadly means this. David Pastrnak and Alex Ovechkin would be co-winners of the Rocket Richard Trophy with 48 goals each. Austin Matthews with 47, just shy. Also, as pointed out by Luke Fox, not just Austin Matthews getting denied a 50-goal season or David Pastrnak, Alex Ovechkin denied his 9th 50-goal season, which he was definitely gonna hit 50. Definitely. He could have gone on a slump and hit 50. Couple other ones, Leon Draisaitl is the Art Ross Trophy winner, 110 points. He had a pretty sizable lead. And Tuukka Rask and Yaroslav Halak will win the William Jennings Trophy, which is like the Vezina, except two people can win it and no one cares. Now, I said this on the podcast, this is contingent on everything coming back safely. Everything has to come back safely in order for me to get behind this. Going forward with the assumption that it will be, I actually think this is great. even the draft lottery. Gary Bettman correctly acknowledged that nothing about this was going to be ideal. Not every team, most teams, are going to be unhappy with parts of this. Like, for example, if you're one of the seven teams that was just told your season is over. If you're the Buffalo Sabres, they had two games in hand on the Montreal Canadiens. They win both of them there in the playoffs playing the Penguins. But because of point percentage, they lose by the slimmest of margins, and we'll never know. And a few other really important things. The news is coming in as I'm shooting this. Couple of other notes from the return to play protocol. Two exhibition games per team, 28 skaters, and as many goalies as you wish to carry. Roster size could change, but that's the current discussion. Okay, that was the first thing that came to mind when we were talking about it on the podcast. You can't just carry two, you can't even carry three. Carolina, in the game where David Ayers played and won, they lost two goalies in the first half of the game. And in a pandemic, it might not be the easiest thing to call up a goalie with a hop, skip, and a jump. This is going to be fascinating to me, and it's a very interesting number. The 2011 Vancouver Canucks, who were notoriously injured, they used 13 defensemen during that cup run that just fell short. They used 27 players in those playoffs. And as I recall, those playoffs were not 5 rounds long. It's entirely possible that a team playing in the Stanley Cup final is just gonna have to play shorthanded because they simply don't have the men. But again, nothing about this is ideal. It's a pandemic. What are you supposed to do? Not play at all, some of you might say, and a lot of people would agree with you. But if they are going to play, they gotta come up with some rules. So, if you're the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Edmonton Oilers, Toronto Maple Leafs, you're any team that was in a playoff spot, but you gotta play this goofy little play-in thing, and you lose, there's good news for you. These are the playoff odds. The great screen grab there, Friege. So basically, Detroit keeps the best odds of getting the first overall pick, or second, third overall pick. Ottawa with two cracks at it. LA, Anaheim, New Jersey, and Buffalo are all still in there. You might notice that teams 8 through 15 don't have a name. If one of the blank teams wins, and it's happened before, it wouldn't be that out of the ordinary, a new draft lottery starts, and each of the eliminated teams from the 5-game play-in have an equal shot, 12.5% chance, at a pick. It could be the third overall pick, the second overall pick, maybe even the first. We're not going to find out for a very long time. So, if you've listened to this video and you listened to Gary Bettman's thing today and you've read all the articles and you're still confused, don't worry, you have over a month to figure this out. But overall, I like it. And this is the attitude that I'm going to carry in. If the Leafs win the Cup this year, or any team wins the Cup this year, you should view it as legitimate. It was hard fought. This is not going to be easy. You still got to go through 5 rounds against the best teams in the NHL. Let's say you play your best of 5, or you're one of the top 4 seeds and you do your round robin, and through 4 rounds of playoff hockey afterward, you beat teams that were in the playoffs. Why should you not view yourself as the Stanley Cup champions? You should. If you don't win the Stanley Cup this year, well, only one team does, and also you get the added intrigue of, you know what, we might just walk away with the first overall pick. Dude, the Leafs, they gave away their first overall pick to Carolina. Yes, it's top 10 protected though. The Leafs could walk away with the first overall pick this summer. The Penguins could walk away with the first overall pick this summer. The Oilers could walk away with it again! Imagine Ottawa has the second and third best odds of winning it, and the Leafs do. Even the third overall pick. Most of the teams I just mentioned were not expecting to get the third overall pick. I think it's easy to complain. There are legitimate gripes with this, for sure. Why not just go with 16 teams? Why not just go with 16 teams? But the NHL had to decide something. The NHL had lots of teams to appease in all of this, and some pretty powerful ones. Ah yes, simply tell the Montreal Canadiens, Chicago Blackhawks, and New York Rangers to go cry in a corner. That's easy for you to say, that's easy for me to say. They got bills to pay. They want people to watch. Heck, I'm surprised they didn't find a way to get the Sabres in there. They had to decide on something. I like it. What do you think? And what do I think about the Leafs' odds against the Columbus Blue Jackets, for example? I'll talk about it in another video later, but honestly, it's jump ball. It's jump ball for absolutely everybody. The Boston Bruins were the best team out of the 24, the Montreal Canadiens the 24th. either team could win that series. I believe it. Dude, these guys haven't played for 2.5 months. Some of them haven't been on ice for 2.5 months. And with the Leafs and Blue Jackets, you get a sneaky rivalry. I've talked about this for a long time. They play each other nasty. They go back and forth in terms of winning games, and they were two of the most injured teams in the entire NHL who get to go, look who we have back at 100%. The Blue Jackets had a ton of guys who were out long-term or weren't at 100%. Seth Jones, Jonas Korpisalo, Josh Anderson. I know he scored 47 goals, but Austin Matthews wore a cast to the All-Star game. Freddie Anderson, something might have been ailing him. Morgan Riley, something was definitely ailing him. What about Ilya Mikheyev? What about him? It's gonna be so weird. I don't know how you predict a series in which teams are both flat and fresh. But that's for another video. Leave a comment in the comment box down below. What do you think of this new system? Do you hate it? Do you love it? Did you hate it at first and then you sort of thought about it and you're like, oh, okay, I guess that'll do. On the brand new Panago Pizza Steve Dangle podcast, we talked about it at length, fresh, right after hearing the news. You'll hear a lot more perspective that I didn't just offer in this video. And I hope I don't have to say this, but I'm gonna say it anyway. I don't want this. I don't want any of this if it's not done safely. There are so many issues. What if a player gets it? How are they going to do testing? Are players going to be trusted to? We'll discuss it another day. I think that's a good podcast topic. For now, going forward with optimism that this will work, I like the plan so far. It's not a complete plan, but I like it so far. Hope you like this video, and that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends that hockey's coming back. In like a month and a half, maybe two or something. We're not sure.